Depicting your imagination is what we can say in small words for augmented reality. Now, if you want to say today I want to look like Spider-Man or I want to look like say Superman, so we will take your face and we will simply project a Superman on your face and you will start looking like Superman. We had never touched this technology before, but as the basic was C#, so we had something related to it. That's why we said, why shouldn't we give a try? Jarvis, as you might be knowing, is the name of Iron Man's computer with whom he corresponds or gives orders. Basically, in this project, what we were trying to do is to make up a car and open it up. Open up the parts of the car and then again close them. We wanted to project a watch on our hand. Now, this can be used for wearing different watches when you don't have actually anyone in real. So, say you have a choice of 10 watches, or you want to try out different watches on your hand, which will suit me best for today's party. You can choose up from any watches, you can slide between watches, and whatever suits your requirements, you can see it on your hand.
We started working with the C# framework, the backend coding part, and for creating the 3D objects, that is the meshes. So we used a Blender, and for our coding part, we used a Unity 3D, that is a game engine. So that is a IDE that integrates together a Mono developer. Marker is nothing but it is a small image, or it can be any image, a PD, a TPDF, a PNG, or a JPEG image. And that image needs to be trained, and that has to be fed, its design and its integrated carvings have to be fed into our machine. So once our machine recognizes that image, it will automatically project any object that has been coded from our side onto that marker. So what we usually do is that we tie that marker onto our wrist and we move and we place that marker in front of the camera. So what our code behind does is that it projects the 3D object, that is the 3D mesh of the watch, on that marker itself. So when a person moves his hand here or there, he will be definitely be seeing his watch being wrapped up on his wrist, and that watch will be moving along with his hand on the screen.
It was a great challenge to understand the Unity 3D and how to do the events, how to capture the events. So firstly, we try to understand the basics, how to work on Unity. Then after understanding the basics, then there was a challenge to capture the hand gestures or event from the user. For a wristwatch, if we saw the large size marker, then it could not be appropriate. So to reduce the size of the marker, this was also a great challenge.
Watch was something that very interesting and very precise. We had to make a model. So we had to model it in such a way that all the details has to be like very much refined and detailed. I have to apply the materials and textures. That was the most challenging part. And exporting to Unity is another interesting and exciting also, because you know, sometimes the materials will not be that accurate. A watch is a stainless steel. I have to apply a stainless steel kind of a material. Later, we'll be adding a textures for that one.
Playing with that by opening and closing the parts of the car. Then after that, we played with some mechanic. On clicking a particular button, a mechanic will appear on the screen. So this was a fun moment.
It's very fun to work also, because we'll be seeing a 3D object in like live, and real time we can interact with the 3D object. That was something fun.
We don't live in an information age anymore. We live in a meta information age. We need to know more than what meets the eye. Everybody is seeking to know more information about what they see, what they're looking at. Augmented reality is one technology that promises to take us into the realm of science fiction. I'm pretty excited. This is awesome stuff.